Let me give a short presentation or a short summary about some tasks of this Southeast European program called Bioregio Carpathians, in which we started to elaborate some, create some common integrated management measures. It is a very ambitious plan, of course, but as we know from the former studies and also from the former presentation, it is necessary to make some common actions to conserve or manage these species. We studied the status of large carnivores, brown bear, wolf and lynx, and also golden jackal in the Carpathian countries, but as the golden jackal is not too frequent in the mountainous areas, I will not speak about jackal. And also herbivores, because I think that it is impossible to speak about conservation without the conservation of the prey of this species. So red deer, roe deer, chamois and bison. I also will not speak about bison because it's a reintroduced species and it has a special status. I also think that these species are very important because of their socio-economic importance, not only for hunting, but some of them can cause conflicts with the humans as they are very common or they have quite large home ranges and territories, they can affect the management of the other stakeholders too. We wanted to evaluate the existing population data and also the planning of the management, the conservation actions, because we wanted to find these common topics which could be the basics of the common integrated management measures. It is a good possibility to compare the management or conservation of the two groups, the large carnivores and the large herbivores, which could be interesting, I think. Okay, the partner countries were the Czech Republic, Hungary, Romania, Serbia, Slovak Republic, and Ukraine. Of course, these countries have very different situation. They have very different populations, so it is very interesting to compare the status in different countries. It was not a real or classical scientific study or scientific survey, because as it is a practical management project, we simply asked the official experts, official conservation experts, and we asked them to send or collect the official data. But as many data are missing, and also the personal background is very important in this management and conservation issues, we were interested in the personal opinions of these experts. So the first question was about the population size of these animals. This is large carnivores, we can compare with the status in different countries. I'm sorry, the letters are very, very small, but I hope that everybody knows the situation in his or she's or her own country. And I can show here that those countries where there is no wolf, there the protection level is the highest. If there are highest populations, then the protection is lower. I can accept personally this situation. There are many discussions and debates about that, because in EU member countries, the country have to follow the EU regulation. So, for example, the Romanian situation with the wolf, is a derogation, so they can hunt it, and the protection level is lower than it was desired by the European legislation. Okay, in some other situations like lynx or bear, we see some deviations from this basic rule. So we see that the protection level is highest or higher than the than it was used, it was would be necessary on the basis of the population size. Okay, if we see the two most important large herbivores, the red deer and the roe deer, then we see that, of course, the protection status is very low. Protection means that zero if it is possible to kill them without any restrictions, and 100% means that it is totally protected and not allowed to disturb, even to disturb the animal. So here you can find that there are differences in the protection level in the different countries, but it is more or less in correlation with the population status, population size of the given species. Okay, it is interesting to compare the large carnivores and the large herbivores on the basis of the data, how detailed data exists on the population densities, data accessibility, data reliability, and applicability to the Carpathian regions. It is important in this study. Okay, as we compare this, we see that these scores of from the experts are on the medium level, so they are not really satisfied with this population data, and the reliability is the weakest. So that's why there are many discussions about the numbers, about the real numbers of this species, and that's why we had to ask the official data, because the experts sent a high variety of the data. Okay, what is important, interesting to me, that there were no difference between the large carnivores and large herbivores. We suppose that as the large carnivores are more threatened species and they are very popular species, they are many studies focus on the large carnivores, even in this area, in this region. We thought that the data on large carnivores will be better, but not. Also, as the large herbivores has some economic interest, so the hunters are interested in that. On the other hand, we can suppose that the hunters have better data. But it is also not true. So this two group is on the same, on the same level. And there were no real correlation between the protection status and the data quality, which is also interesting, because surprising, because we supposed, as naive scientists, we supposed that the protection status is based on good quality data. The higher protection, the better data set. It is not true. Okay, we thought that at least the harvest data and harvest data quality would be better than the so-called estimation of the population numbers. We find a little increase in that, so these scores were better slightly, but not too high. And the wolf data were the worst. The last question was about the planning, management or conservation planning. And we asked for the opinion about the accessibility, reliability, and application in practice. As you heard from the previous lecture, previous presentation, there are many problems with that, and I agree with that, or study supports the previous conclusions that there are no plans for every species and in every countries. Large herbivore plants are better than the large carnivore plants, and reliability is at medium level or a little bit weakest. But the application in the practice is very poor for large carnivores. So it seems that population and harvest data provide weak background to management and conservation. We suggest that monitoring must be improved. Also, the harvest data and knowledge on large herbivores, as they are game species, are better, but only slightly. And the higher protection level means poorer knowledge. Conservation management plans are better and mainly elaborated for large carnivores, because this is a requirement from the EU. And as it is not the same with the large herbivores, usually there are no protection plans or conservation plans or management plans for the large herbivores. But the reliability and practicability of these plans are very weak, so we need more practical and common plans. Okay, this is a little summary about the ideas about these possible common integrated management measures. It is not too surprising that the first is the common monitoring system, establishing a common monitoring system, and after that, common scientific background. Without this, it is impossible to make any practical conservation action. Also, the common structure of the management planning would be useful if everybody followed that, and so on. What are the main research priorities? Of course, again, development of monitoring methods, because without that, it seems that we cannot step forward with this. Also, research on habitat use and suitability, movement, genetical background, and so on. So, it seems that we have many works to do, and it would be very important to do it as quick as possible, because in the next years, the more holistic approach in these conservation and management actions will be the priority of the European Union. We have to make something on population level instead of local levels, and for this, we need these data. And thank you for your attention.